Live from the Sea Delay Arena in Belleville, Ontario, Canada. I'm DNP, and alongside me is Flashee, and we are set to take you through the action of Game 1 tonight. We'll have Game 2 a little later on. Games 3 and 4, we'll see when they happen. But just for now, it is the first two games of the series of the first final in this league's history. Before we get to that, though, we've got some interviews, some players we'd like to talk to down at ice level. And I believe the first person we're going to be speaking with is Mitch Meaner.
Yeah, so let's get him in here.
All right, Flashee is with Mitch Meaner.
All right, Mitch, welcome to the LHB final, game number one. What is something you guys are just looking forward to in this game?
We're looking forward to obviously getting a chance to compete for the cup. You know, I don't think at the start of the season we expected to be here. We went through some ups and downs. Our owner made a couple of moves to make us a better team. And are nervous for this game. I mean, I would say we're somewhat nervous, but we're confident too, and we're looking forward to this first game. Chance to compete against the best team in the league.
I do notice that you are rocking a different name. Tell us about your name change situation.
Legal issues, my friend.
Understandable. Let's get a word from Krillis, the team owner. Bring him in here. All right, Krillis, what's one of the things that you are going to try to take advantage of the Blizzard tonight?
The biggest thing is, one, careless mistakes or just trying to catch Uyghur out of position. And I think we're prepared quite well for this game. I'm not really too nervous with my team. Pretty happy with the team. I was able to put it together.
Nice.
I'm looking for a fun series.
DMP, would you like to ask anything?
Well, you guys had you guys had a pretty hard fought series in the last round. One of the things I noticed that was really well done was the face offs. Do you think taking draws and such will be harder against Belleville, and how do you expect to capitalize on that?
Face are obviously harder. I mean, I don't think the draft really knew the game too much, didn't really get on enough to know it, and we're taking, I think statistically, the best face-off taker right now in Jets or Birdo, so it's just gonna be a not really like a guaranteed win for anyone.
How do you expect those winning draws to affect the game?
I think you touched on this last game, but winning the draw gives your team possession, and it's pretty important in this game.
Thank you.
All right. Well, good to hear from you. We'll talk to you possibly during the intermission or in the post-game interviews, so good luck.
Thank you. Bye. I'll see you guys later.
Bye.
See you guys.
Well, it's going to be an interesting series, to say the least. Both teams came off of a couple of blowout wins, but in the case of the Belleville Blizzard, I believe. No, Charlotte Shipwreck. They come into this series having come off of a hard-fought series against the California Drought. They did blow them out in games one and three. The drought did give them did make them work hard for it in 2 and 4, and easily could have been here, so. But at the other end of the ice, we've got the Belleville Blizzard, who have been great all season long. I think this is going to be a hard series. In fact, we've got a couple of good players. Statistically speaking, we got Birdo leading with the Belleville Blizzard, and I'm kind of awkward right now. I don't know. I get the points leaders, I guess. We could talk about that now. Points leaders, sure. For both sides. We got Birdo XD, who is the points leader for the Belleville Blizzard. 9 goals, 5 assists for a total of 14 points. On the opposite side of the ice, we got Krillis, a total of 14 goals, 8 assists. Both of those players have proven time and again that they are valuable to their teams in these playoff runs. Again, while Krillis, the one difference, I guess, between the tales of the two different series is it really seemed that the California drought, really, when they fell behind, they just kind of gave up. And so, while yes, the stats are pretty, seem to be pretty high for the Shipwreck coming into this series, some of those numbers may have been padded a little, just by...
Based on their opponent, right?
Based on the opponent, because although the Greyhounds, and no offense to you, Flashee, because you were on that team, but although the Greyhounds may not have quite had the skill to compete and make it to the final, they at least tried their hardest and still, you know, lost.
But a valiant effort, I would say.
Put in a great effort. They made it as hard as they could for the Belleville Blizzard to get to this final. And that, in turn, has... Whereas with the drought, they
gave up. They gave up pretty fast.
They kind of gave up.
So,
When they came on, like, when they were playing with full intent on, you know, trying to win the game, it was a close matchup. But here we are with the Charlotte Shipwreck in the final. They managed, both teams won. I think the numbers from this series are going to be a lot lower, and I think they're going to be a lot closer. Don't count Belleville out. Don't count Charlotte out. Both teams are good.
It's up in the air, really, because I've seen these players scrimmage in games, and I've definitely seen Krillis and Cryptiv outplay Birdo and Jets at some times. So you never know what's going to happen tonight. And... like you said, the point leaders we still see on the screen here are not entirely indicative on who's the better, you know, goal scorer or, you know, playmaker, because like you were saying, just the matchups were different. So we'll really see who's better tonight, because they're going up against each other.
And some of the geese that we kind of talked about earlier is, like, some of the key areas that teams probably need to be working on. Face-offs are important. You know, Krillis noted it. We talked about it quite a bit in the last series with California and Charlotte. We noted that Krillis was really good on those draws throughout much of that last series, and those... that leads to possession, leads to early goals. We'll see if those numbers will continue for the Charlotte Shipwreck. I don't know about stats for the on draws for the Belleville Blizzard, but maybe you might have something to add to that.
Yeah, definitely. Krillis has figured it out with faceoffs, and with Cryptiv as his winger, it's deadly. If you give up a ozone, if you lose an ozone, or sorry, a defensive zone draw, it's brutal if you're the opponent of Shipwreck. So definitely Austin, I believe, is in net tonight for the Blizzard, is going to need to take that into account. Do not hold on to the puck when you don't need to. Try to get it out of your zone. You don't want those in-zone face-offs.
Well, we'll have to see what the series holds. The teams have headed back into locker rooms. I think we're about ready to get it underway here. First off, we got some intros, and then we'll be ready to go for... we got intros, anthems, and then shall be ready to go for the first game of the LHB Season 1 Final.
Alright, we're just waiting for the go-ahead from the home team as to when they're ready to go, and we'll start their intro. Are you connected to the audio client?
Yeah, I am.
Okay. All right, here we go. Thank you.
The anthems have been sung, the intros have been done, we are set and ready to go for game one of the LHB final.
What a entertaining introduction there made by the Belleville Blizzard media team organization.
Starting netminders, we've got Uyghur in net for the Belleville Blizzard. At the other end, it's Mitch Meander between the pipes for the Charlotte Shipwreck. On the ice, we've got Krillis and Jets centering both squads, and they are about to take the first draw of the game, and it goes to Jets 23, and we're underway. Crypto will bring it to the near side boards to get it across the line, forced to the boards by Birdo. Looks toward the point, Birdo now clears the zone, getting it up to Jets 23. Defended well by Jaden. And Charlotte gets it to the line, and Krillis will get it in the neutral territory. Birdo ensures that the Shipwreck stay in the neutral zone. And now Jets 23 goes to work in the offensive zone. Jaden trying to get a stick on it, potentially clear it out. Behind the net, Jets gives it for Birdo. Birdo, pass blocked by Jaden. Out front, Jets waiting there and was intercepted. Forced to the boards by Luke. Across, it goes to Jets 23. Jaden will send it back up. Birdo across the line, shoots off the post with a shot to start this one. Great chance there for the Belleville Blizzard. Back across, Birdo couldn't get it. Cryptive across the line. Luke clears it. Sent to the boards. Back the other way comes Krillis. He'll get it in. Luke airmills one back to neutral territory. Shot there! That's off the pipe!
Wow, not even 2 minutes in and we have two posts already.
Pass to no one. Krillis looking at Cryptive, and now they get it across the line. Cryptive a chance. Saved there by Uyghur. Comes out to the line. Jets 23 turns it around. Clears the zone. Jaden up the wing. Back across it comes to Krillis. He'll send it in. It's a pad stop. He'll let it go. And it's played by Birdo. Birdo almost lost it to Cryptive. And now up the wing comes Jets. He'll carry it behind the corner. Fans chanting their desires for the cup. Krillis trying to work it out. Birdo will send it back. Hops one over to the corner. They'll battle along the trapezoid line. Jets 23 fed one out front, but Cryptive will get there before trouble. Brought to the boards by Birdo. Cleared out of the zone. Sent in. Now here's a chance, Jaden, but Birdo got there before he could take the shot. Back in. Krillis sends one that's wide. It's a glove save for Uyghur, but he'll let it go. Played behind by Luke. Belleville across the line into neutral territory. Turn back around. Cryptive. Now for Krillis. He'll hop it in. Skids just wide, and now Luke and Cryptive battle for it. Birdo digs it out. Cryptive, though, forces it back in, takes a shot that doesn't reach the net. And now Birdo will get it back. Pass for Jets, flew a bit ahead of him. But they managed to get it into the offensive zone. Across! Birdo! And Meemner got there in time to make the save. A minute 34 to go here in the first period. Jets won the draw back to Birdo. His shot turned over, and I think he broke the stick on that play. Had to come to the bench to get a new one. Shot there! Rebound score! Cryptive! And Charlotte's on top here with the first goal of the game. It's 1-0.
All right, let's take a look at that. Cryptive just uses the boards to his advantage to get around Luke. His first shot gets blocked by Austin, but Austin gets kind of discombobulated, and the rebound that Cryptive gets himself puts it in.
And short, that's short side. Early... Oh, sorry.
Yeah, sorry, short side.
That's the early start that Charlotte wanted. And that has quieted the crowd here in Belleville. Krillis wins the draw, sends it in, and it's a glove save for Uyghur. He'll let it go. Played behind by Birdo. Out towards Cryptive. Birdo forcing it out across the line through the neutral zone. Jaden will hop it up to Krillis, and Charlotte will regroup. They'll get it in. Lost it, and now Belleville with it. It's Luke, intercepted by Krillis, who will get it to the line, but not out, as Luke gets it back for Belleville. forced to the boards by Krillis. Taken around, Birdo works against Krillis, the defender. Looking toward the point. Now it's out of the zone. Jaden and Krillis working. Birdo gets it back in. Centering feed for Jets is another glove save and a whistle. With 29.8 to go by Mimner.
Belvo's had some chances, but none of them have been shots on goal.
This faceoff is won by Jets, but it's intercepted by the Shipwreck, and Cryptiv gets it out. Turns back, looking at the point, Jaden with the pass crossed over the line. They have to regroup as there is onside. Jets will get it through. Sent in. Jaden gets to it. Charlotte trying to work it out. Chance there! Birdo denied! Behind the net, out for Jets. And he didn't get the shot. We come to the first intermission where the score is 1-0.
And wow, Belleville gets their first shot of the whole game there within the final, 10 seconds? Maybe 5? Unlike the Belleville Blizzard, normally they're the ones that prevent the other team from getting shots. So, kind of a weak period from them. Looks like we are going to go for an interview here with Shipwreck. We'll bring Rockwatt in here. Rockwatt, go ahead and... I need to message him. All right, Rockwatt, go ahead and just stay where you are. I've got the camera on you. Well, you guys came out very strong, preventing Belleville from getting more than one shot there, which is unlike that team. Normally, they're the ones preventing the other team from getting shots. What's working for you guys so far?
We've kind of been playing better defense than usual. We got to chill out a little bit. We got end of the... That period there was kind of a little bit shaky, I guess, but we gotta calm down a little bit, keep shooting, get more chances, keep doing what we're doing, kind of be a little bit more clean.
I was able to catch some of your afternoon practice with your team. How big of a deal is practicing before the game? Does it help you? Does it hurt you? What are your thoughts?
Well, it's huge. We kind of went over I wasn't really there for a lot of it, but I know we went over a lot of breakouts and stuff that we kind of need, defense. It's huge against a team like this, so, yeah.
Yeah. All right, I'll let you get back to your team. Thank you for taking the interview, and good luck to you and the rest of the game.
Yep, thank you. See ya.
All right, DNP, what are your thoughts going into the second period?
I think all around it was a pretty even period. Just the Shipwreck managed to find a way to sneak one past Uyghur to get the first goal of the game. I have no doubt that Belleville's going to find a way back into this one. We're just getting started.
Yeah, you're right about that. Belleville never goes down easy. They're going to make it really difficult. And here they are, taking the ice, getting ready for period number 2 of game 1 of the LHB final.
Second period. It'll be Krillis and Jets once again in the faceoff, Don. I think Jets was better in that period, but the problem was, I don't know if he wasn't putting enough power or what, but even on the times that he did win the draws, the Shipwreck managed to get control of the puck. So we'll have to see if that improves in this second period. Jets wins another one. Gets it into the zone, and he has control for now. Centering feed, no one there. That's another thing I noticed a couple times, those passes to nowhere. Krillis missed the connection, and now Luke will get it. All pass almost got on the tape of Cryptiv, who is not on the same team. Chance there, directed toward the net, save made by Mimner. Brought around, it's Birdo. Birdo centering feed, Jets was there. Luke gets it across the line. Krillis now hops it over Birdo. And now they're in. Luke turns back. Cryptiv, centering feed, and Jets was there. Krillis, his shot blocked by Luke. Jets lost it. Luke will hop it in. And now Jets will go to work. Turn back. Looking toward the point. Here's Birdo. Lost it. Luke couldn't get through Jaden, and now it's cleared. Cryptiv almost got an interception. Birdo across looking at Jets. And now it's cleared out. Cryptiv lost it. Luke with it across the line. Waits with it, pressured by Krillis. Luke holds on to it. Trying to get it out to the point. Birdo across, Jets shot! Blocked, and a save for Mitch Mimner.
Birdo goes to shoot, but then decides to pass it to Jets right on his tape, but Mimner gets there in time, saves that.
Krillis wins that draw, gets it to Jaden. Back now, Birdo across the line. Jaden gets it out. Krillis slips one in, slides it past Luke, and now he'll carry it behind his goal. Krillis, though, will steal it, sneaks it away, carries it behind the net, looking over his options. Jets 23 will take it back, and he'll pop it out, deflect it off the boards, and it's back in on the stick of Krillis. Taken to the corner, Birdo will power it out. Luke will angle one up to Jets. Chance! Save! No rebound! It hit the post! A great chance for Belleville to tie the game, and somehow Mitch Mimner gets a glove on it. Jets wins the draw. Birdo takes the shot. It's blocked. Chance there at the side. Hit the post again, and it will get covered by Mitch Mimner.
Belleville putting on the pressure now. Couple chances in a row.
Jets wins the draw again, but it goes to a Charlotte stick as Jaden clears it out. Luke trying to regroup for Belleville. Krillis across for Cryptiv as Charlotte tried to bring it across the line. They lost it, and now Jets will get it in. Birdo couldn't quite control it. Here's Krillis across the neutral zone. Taken to the board, sticked away by Uyghur, and now it's out. Through neutral territory. Jets had it, lost it. Now Luke sends it up for Birdo, who tried to get it maybe back across for Jets, but the pass didn't get there. And now they'll have to forecheck. Shot there, blocked out front by Krillis. Pass across. Jets looking for Birdo. Jaden across the line. Centering it, shoots it. But Luke gets there and swipes it away from trouble. Swept it out. Birdo, shot blocked. Cleared out to Luke. He'll head it up to Jets. Shot! Score! We're tied! Jets 23 ties the game. And Eggs on Toast has come out of the ice. Chance there, score! Birdo! And Belleville's got the lead!
Wow.
And this team just took a 180.
Eggs on Toast gets that puck across the blue line. Loses it. But Birdo, at the blue line, just takes a shot on net, goes short side on Mimener. That's two goals on two shots.
Line changes for the Belleville Blizzard, and that immediately paid off as Eggs on Toast got it to Birdo. And they managed to get the lead and snatch it away from Charlotte. Jaden works it up for Cryptive there across the line, and Charlotte's playing behind again. Or rather, playing behind for the first time in this game, but this not for the first time in this playoffs. Chance, shot, score! Luke, and it's 3-1!
Wow. Three shots, three goals. Jaden just loses it in the neutral zone. Luke steals it from him. It's on the breakaway. Puts it far side on Mimner.
And just like that, what once was a one-goal lead for the Charlotte Shipwreck is now double that for the Belleville Blizzard. Charlotte has not been in the lead the whole time, but I don't know that they've ever really been down by, I don't know if they've been down by two. So it'll be interesting to see how they weather the storm here. As we go to our second intermission, and we'll talk to one of the Belleville Blizzard in just a few moments.
Hey, Eggs on Toast. So you got some ice time that period, and immediately it paid off for your team. Tell us about that first goal that, or was it the second goal?
It was the
second goal for your team. You brought it in the zone, and just tell us what played out from there.
Yeah, it was quite simple, really. Jets got off after the goal. Brito told me to take the faceoff, which I wasn't expecting. I happened to win it. Forward left, I brought it in, and I think it was Jaden who poked it, but Birdo, he happened to poke it right to Birdo. Birdo rips, Birdo doesn't miss from there, so,
mm-hmm. Yeah, your first two periods, five shots total, it's not that many, but your last three went in, so does quantity matter, or does quality matter?
I think definitely, in this case, particularly, it's quality. There are some other cases where I think it can be quantity or quality, but for us, I feel like we're very much a quality over quantity team, and that's what we try to play with. We try to set up the perfect plays instead of just like trying to get as many shots on as possible, just not thinking it through as in thinking like, oh, there could be a better play. That's what we try to do, is we always think, is this the right move to shoot?
All right, final question for you. What's your strategy going into the third period? You're going to keep scoring or lock it down on defense?
We'll see what the captain wants. Yeah, we'll probably do a bit of both. Depends on sort of how the first 2 minutes go.
All right, thank you very much, Eggs. And good luck to the third period.
Thank you.
Well, Flashee, do you got a question of the game?
Well, I do, but it's BHL Season 1. Is that acceptable to ask right now?
I think it is.
Okay. Who was on the ice on the game-winning BHL Season 1 Cup goal, which four players were on the ice for that goal? Should we answer it now?
I think we answer that at the very end of the broadcast.
All right, we'll try to remember.
Give people some time to think about it.
All right.
Third period is about to get underway. Krillis and Eggs on Toast will once again do battle at center ice. It seemed to work for Belleville. Eggs played about the last couple of minutes of that second period. And since he's come on the ice, Belleville has just had an explosion of scoring. And he'll win the draw again and get it in. Works it to the corner. Pressure by Krillis. Managed to get it out. Looking toward the point, but the pass gets across the line. Birdo has to get it back in. Centering feed becomes a glove save and released by Mitch Meaner. And now Birdo working it out. Centering! Oh my goodness! This goes in! How?
Let's take a look at the replay on that. Birdo takes it around the net, centers it to nobody, right? Rockwatt then, wow, okay, so Rockwatt is putting it into his own net. It's basically going to be an own goal, but then Birdo taps it right before it crosses the line, and that's his goal.
First shift of the night for Rockwatt, and he nearly puts it in his own goal. Becomes an easy tap-in for Birdo, as you said. I saw that as it happened, but wasn't sure if Birdo was the one that finished it or not. But regardless, it's a 4-1 lead for Belleville. As Krillis brings it around, shot blocked by Luke, and the puck gets cleared to the neutral zone. Brought back in by Krillis. Centering feed. Is a glove save for Uyghur. He lets it go. And Birdo brings it back around. Krillis trying to take it away. Birdo intercepted by Jaden. Now it gets back to his stick. He lets one go. And it goes wide. Jaden and Birdo battle. Centering feed. Birdo. Chance. Another one. Jets was there. Now he'll get it back. Krillis, though, clears the zone. It's out. Luke back across the line, intercepted by Jaden. Krillis in a neutral territory. Jets has it. Centering chance. Shot saved by Meemner. Centering feed didn't connect. Or no one was there for the rebound, rather. And now it's cleared out. Luke turning it around. Gets it in for Belleville. Krillis intercepts. He'll bring it around. Luke clears it out. Or rather, Krillis does. Chance there. Shot score! Birdo, third goal of the game. It's a hat trick. And it's 5-1 Blizzard.
Just a quick shot. Once again, Jaden with the direct giveaway, or actually with Birdo with the takeaway there, right at the blue line.
And Jets will win that draw. Almost went right to the tape of Rockwood. And Belleville's got the zone again. Corrective works it out. Luke, though, in neutral territory, intercepts, got it back in momentarily, but Krillis will get to it for Charlotte. Birdo turns it around, gets it to Jets. Run around, Krillis. works it into neutral territory. Jets back across the line, lost it. Birdo to get it back. Across. Jets couldn't get the zone. Birdo now is in. Centering feed, looking at Jets, he scores! It's 6-1!
Jets nets his second of the game with a complete breakdown on defense for the Shipwreck. Left basically a 2-on-0. Birdo just takes it into the corner, centers it, and Jets is right there perfectly.
And to think at the beginning of this game, the Shipwreck might have won it.
Yeah, Shipwreck were dominating early on. But Belleville warmed up.
Took a bit for Belleville to get their legs going, but once they found them, they came on hard.
I think they've scored on 6 consecutive shots, if I'm not mistaken.
Maybe. Birdo across, Jets fanned on it. Krillis will get to it, but it's held in.
Jets with the opportunity to get
Jets
the hat trick.
Again. Back to Birdo. Birdo out for Jets. Shoots. Oh, it's on the line. And Mamner makes the save. 1:15 to go. The hat trick is denied for now.
Wow, so Krillis actually makes the save on that. It was about to cross. Krillis comes over and hits it so it stays on the goal line, and then Mamener was able to glove it.
Krillis won the draw, but it is sent back in. Eggs will steal it away. Lost it. Krillis gets it out. Across. Luke. Turned it over. Kryptiv gets it in. Centering feed becomes a glove save and a whistle. Thanks to Uyghur.
He's been great tonight. 6 saves on 7 shots.
Hasn't faced much in the second half of this game, but when he's had to, he's been strong. Oh, a chance there for Rockwood. Does not go. Shot by Kryptiv blocked. Rockwood. Takes it, lost it to Luke, and now Kryptiv gets it back. Waits with it, lost it, Luke clears it out. Through neutral territory, Krillis trying to reverse it. And now Jets goes to work. Out to the point, Luke, lost it. Jets got it back. Shoots, and it is caught and released by Mimner. And now Eggs on Toast will work it behind. Out to the point. Pass didn't hit Luke. Shot blocked. Jets lost it. And that will do it. After 3 periods, shots are 9-7. And the final score is 6-1 as Belleville will take the first game of the series.
That game took a turn after that first period, more so at the end of the second.
I talk about a complete 180 and then some.
Yeah.
Like, what was that? 540?
Like, yeah, for real.
Because it took... Because Charlotte dominated that first period. Came out, 1-0. And then the Blizzard came back, and they came back with a vengeance. Netting 6 unanswered goals to win this one. I don't know if we've got any post-game interviews or not.
Go ahead and see if...
While we await any interviews, we can give the answer to the question of the game. Question asked was, what four players were on the ice for the series-winning goal in Game 5 of the Season 1 BHL Final? And unless I'm mistaken, the answer to that was me, you, Sambros, and the EB Gamer.
That is correct. So yeah, Flashee, DNP, Sambros, EB were on the ice. And bonus question, who scored that goal? The answer to that is you're the one and only commentator here, DNP underscore 10. So,
The San Francisco Flight won that series the first final. We'll see who will be the first final winner for the LHB. Do we have any post-game interviews?
I'm just going to go to their media room and see if there's anyone in there. It's like they're all in the locker room right now. All right, here comes the team owner and goaltender for the Belleville Blizzard.
Hello?
Yeah. All right. Oh,
Flashee.
What's up?
I might have stole your, might have accidentally stole the stream scheduling when I scheduled the other one. Let me look.
It's still alive. All right. Okay. Well, congratulations on the win. To be honest, after that first period, we were not in high hopes for you guys. What changed after that first period?
I think, so we haven't played in like almost a month, it seems. So it was just a little bit rusty. We got on, we were a little bit nervous. And then we figured out the flow of the game. Eggs on Toast got on. God moment, plus three. And you know, we just went from there, popped off. The whole second goal was all Eggs on Toast, so I just picked up an easy rebound, and then we figured things out. And then, of course, Austin kept us in there. I mean, he only had 7 shots. He saved 6 of them. You mean, big saves made by him, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Austin did a great in net, giving up an early one, but being solid for the rest of the game. It looks like you guys had 6 goals on 6 consecutive shots. I believe that is the case. And I was asking Eggs on Toast this, but you know, what do you think is more important to you? Is it quantity or quality on shots?
Definitely quality. I mean, obviously, if you're not generating anything, you gotta put anything you can for that. But if our chances are going in, we definitely take the lesser amount of chances than more shots. In.
Yeah, this was a low-scoring game, considering we've had higher-scoring games. But you still managed to net 6, so that's pretty impressive. DMP, do you have any questions?
Well, you've got 1 win under your belt. Talk about any strategies you might have concerning the next couple of games going forward, and how you might, you know, get those next 2 wins you need.
We're gonna play how we played. I mean, we locked down. I think we could do better on the defensive side. Offense, we figured it out. I think now we gotta figure out our defensive game.
Do you think you'll be playing? My bad.
Jets, you have any thoughts?
No, I agree. Just playing our game, staying the same, keeping the momentum from this game to the next game, but at the same time,
not knowing that, or knowing it's a whole new game and anything could happen, so just be ready for that.
Sure.
Flashee, go ahead.
Do you think, or will you be playing Exontos more in this game based on his performance?
We're just gonna roll with what we were doing. If the time comes, we're gonna give Exo. I mean, we gave him more ice time after that. I mean, he won us draws and stuff, so we're obviously not gonna overplay him. We're obviously not gonna underplay him. We're gonna play what we feel is right for the game and the situation.
All right, well, I think that's all we have for you guys. Congratulations on the win. We'll let you celebrate, and I'll get started with game number two pretty soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey. All right, send us off, DMP.
Well, thank you guys for tuning in to game one of the LHB final. We'll be right back in a few moments for game number two, where the Charlotte Shipwreck are going to take a look and try and even this series, split it up on the road, and head back to home ice with a chance to take a lead in this series. But if the Belleville Blizzard can get it done, they'll have a chance to win the series in the next one. But until then, I've been D&B, and alongside me has been Flashee. We hope you enjoyed this one, and we'll see you in the next one. Take care.